Tabeling and Piek of the Netherlands up against Tang Chunmen and Sei Yin Suet of Hong Kong, China. Here's how the draw was panned out, the mixed doubles. Top seeds gone by the wayside, Puerto Rico and Terra Tanachai. And we're going to see that second semi-final, the bottom one. And that'll be our final match today. But we are concentrating initially on that top semi-final. Tang and Sei will start favourites. They are higher ranked. They are a lower seed, as you can see. But got a feeling this might be close. Umpires are on court. Let's wait for the introductions. Two very popular pairs. It is the fifth meeting, actually. You can see Tang and Sei lead 3-1 on the head-to-head. The last meeting was the Indonesia Open quarter-final that you can see on screen. In fact, Tabeling and Piek's only win in the previous four meetings was in the first one nearly 5 years ago. So let's give you a bit of information then about some of these players, starting off with Robin Tabeling, ranked 17th as a pair. That highest rank of 8 was only 6 months ago. European Games gold medalists in Poland last year. Double Olympian, Selina Piek, reached the women's doubles quarterfinal in both Rio and the Tokyo Games. Never won a Super 300 or higher, these two. They did win the Dutch Open, a lesser event, although they got to the final of the French Open a couple of years ago. That's a Super 750. So that was a really good effort. In terms of their route through to this semi-final, there it is, taken to 3 games in both the first and second round. But then yesterday they knocked out the number one seeds in less than 40 minutes. So that bit of a paradox, really. Other side of the net then, Tang Chunmen and Sei Yin Suet. There's Tang, 28 years of age now. They were at number 2 back in 2018. Won their first title together 8 years ago. It was the Chinese Taipei Masters. And his partner in life as well as on the court, Sei Yin Suet, lost in the bronze medal match at the Olympics in Tokyo to Watanabe and Higashino. She carried the flag though, did Sei Yin Suet. in Japan, a massive honour. They were taken to three games by both Labsfus and Lohau, and also by Tan and Lai, but got the better of both of those. It's in Suman, is in charge of this one from the umpire's chair, and Renner Unt will be the service judge here. Okay, stand by for the player introductions. So here we go in this first mixed double semi. What a great rally for starters. Well, they're going to be up, well, both pairs will be up for it, but I was listening to Robin Tabeling doing an interview earlier, and he basically lives about an hour's drive from here. So he doesn't need to stay at a hotel. It's like a home tournament, he says. And I really think they fancy their chances today. 51-shot rally for starters. He gets anything like that, he will just make hay. Attention, man. Absolute gift. He's not the tallest guy, he's 5'10", but he's got great spring, he's got so much experience. Top-class match player. I just always think he's got the answer to most problems that are posed for this pair. They've won a lot more than they've lost down the years. Brilliant from Tabeling, absolutely brilliant. How on earth did he do that from on the ground? There's one, there's two.
And it's over. 3-0.
Lurking with intent around the net, saying to it. Mentioned they've won more than they've lost. Five World Tour titles, including a Super 500 in Malaysia, won the high-low last year. Lost in a couple of Super 750 finals as well, so it could have been even more. Handy net cords for the Dutch pair. Wouldn't be denied.
Service over. 6-5.
Can't believe how many service faults we've had today. So many. Both the singles and the doubles. Well, he read that serve and just put it away beautifully. There's another one to add to the growing list. His judgment from Say, and the Dutch pair move in front. So a handy two-point lead for the Dutch pair as they go for the mid-game break. That's 3 points, though, thrown away by the Hong Kong Chinese pair on service errors. Just wonder if Tang and Say are going to live to regret those service errors. I think they've looked the more threatening pair when a rally is developed, but just made a bit of a gift of those points lost on serve to their opponents. They've had a couple of handy net calls as well. Tabeling and Piek. Again, she goes for the flick serve. Good lead. I think I've often seen Tang and Say make quite so many unforced errors. Oh, was that called in? Yeah, I must say, I just assumed that it was out, but no issues with that. So uncharacteristic, these mistakes. Not that the Dutch pair will mind at all. It's normally so reliable, Tang Chun Man.
Oh!
Another brilliant shot. Well, they've got the momentum with them, that's for sure. I just thought when, almost when I saw them earlier in the venue, they just looked like they had absolute faith in their ability to get them into the final tomorrow. And remember, this is against a pair that have beaten them three times in the previous three meetings. That's another really wild shot. I mean, that missed the green flooring completely, the blue. And that's a meter or so wide of it being acceptably on the line. 3 points away then. It's contagious, the service errors. Close again now. Well, he's making absolutely everything at the moment, Tabeling. Six game points for the number five seeds. That net cord will help. They will not care. 21 points to 15. Tabeling and Piek take the opening game, and deservedly so, against a surprisingly below par Tang and Se. They trail. One game to love.
Second.
Would certainly expect to see a response here from Tang and Say. Continue to ask most of the questions.
One love. Service point fall.
Absolutely hammered. Beautifully placed serve, really was. Just the wrong side of a line, that one. Maybe just a little too delicate there from Piek. Much better. Pushed it wide. Just get the impression that Tang in particular is starting to read Tabeling's deception shots. As they kind of, he kind of gradually took control of that last rally. Oh.
round is over. 5-6.
Mistakes creeping in now as Tang and Say start to take control of the second game, as kind of thought they might do. So they were distinctly second best in the opening game. Mistakes starting to creep in now, the Dutch pair. Tang and Say look like they've refloated the ship, that look like it might be just lurching onto the rocks in the opening game. It's wide, and it's a healthy lead at the mid-game break. Tang and Say looking like forcing a decider here. Surprised him with the flicker. Tabeling way with again. Almost unrecognizable from the way they played in the opening game, these two. Although, to be fair, I think Tang and Say have clearly raised their level. Well, no call of out, so Tang wants to challenge, wants Hawkeye to have a look at this. I think this might be close. Called a decent piece of the line. Well, it works in the end, maybe not by the prescribed method. That's nice placement. Very nice placement. Nicely dealt with by Steve Sweat.
Service over, 17-12.
Well, maybe not quite done and dusted yet, this second game. Oh, that's a good flicker. Well, that's just pure reaction. Absolutely brilliant. I'm not sure she knows how she did it. Just notches up the pressure a little bit, not quite over the line yet. Tabeling and Piek still just kind of nipping at their toes at the moment. Got out of jail there. So, five game points then, to level the match here. For Tang and Say. That's long by a distance. That'll work. Well, outclassed in the first game, but right back in business in the second. 21-16. Tang and Say looking good again, and they level the match at one game all. Well, you would think, wouldn't you, that Tang and Say psychologically would have the edge. Oh, beautifully placed. Absolutely perfectly into the corner of the court. Oh, absolutely nailed. It's right in line with that. And it did not deviate one iota. It was arrow straight from Tang. Absolutely threw himself into the shot. Well, just the start that Tang and Say would have wanted in this decider. Well, you can only resist for so long under that kind of pressure. Excellent. Right at the hip. Very, very difficult to deal with. That was wild from Tang. That was really wild.
6-5.
Well, they wouldn't be denied. Brilliant pressure from the Dutch pair. Suddenly found a spark from somewhere. 7-5. A little angle there as well from Selina Piek. Long by a fair distance that. Oh, that might have been going wide. Well, it's providing fantastic entertainment, this. It really is. It really is. That was a bit short. Or maybe it wasn't. Well, they want to have a look. I thought it was short. Let's have a look. Was absolutely certain it was short, and it was by a long way, long way. Another challenge.
Out.
Long way out. Long way out.
So, can they see it out from here with this three-point lead, the Dutch pair? It's a good start. Made that look ridiculously easy. Have found Tabeling's power tough to cope with today, those two. But it comes down to strength of character now for the Dutch pair, you fancy. And that's sort of exactly what I was talking about. Would be the only worry. It's not that those two don't have the talent, but sometimes temperament wise especially at pressurized moments, can really make the difference between getting across the line and not. Bit of a snatch from Piek. On terms. That was a clever shot from Sei Ying Su. I think just completely surprised Tabeling. Pressure's affecting everyone out there. She can argue as much as she likes, but she's not going to get any joy. The umpire will always support service judge. Just get the feeling that maybe their best opportunity has passed them by. Tabeling and Piek. So reliable for so much of the match, Tabeling, but just when he needs it most, seems to have deserted him. The magic touch here. That not just the point but for the self-belief and the confidence as well. That's going to be challenged. At this juncture, anything vaguely close will be challenged. I don't think it's going to get overturned, but he wants to have a look. Yeah, well won. Good. What a topsy-turvy match this is. so much pressure out there. Especially for Piek and Tabeling, haven't obviously got the same kind of CV as Tang and Tse. Never won a Super 300 event, the Dutch pair, and this might be their best chance, but this is a massive point. Can they get on terms again? Just about got to that. Well, it was unrelenting, the pressure Tabeling was putting on Tang Chun Men. And in the end, he got the better of it. Long. So here's a match point for Robin Tabeling and Selina Piek. Wow, would you believe it? At least give yourself a chance to win a rally. Old nemesis, service fault. Had it gone in, everyone would have said it was brilliant, but it didn't, and it wasn't. And it's 20 all. Well, no one is immune from pressure. No one. Second chance then for the Europeans to book a place in tomorrow's final. Oh. And that's long, and again it was an opportunity. Because Tang and Tse were in trouble at one point in that rally. Tse almost had to play the shuttle over a partner from pretty close range. And that gave Tabeling a chance and he couldn't take it. So on we go. And after saving two match points, Tang and Tse now have one of their own. That's wide, and they have fallen short again, Tabeling and Piek. Great match though, 23-21 in the third. And it's Tang Chun Men and Tse Ying Suet who go through. It really could have gone either way. They'll be massively disappointed, the Dutch pair, they really will. Thank you. So there is the tail of the tape. 15-21, 21-16, 23-21. 65 minutes, the match time. Up next, we will go back to men's singles for our penultimate match on semi-final stage. Xiao Junfeng takes on the Dane Rasmus Gemke. That's next. Penultimate match today. It's a men's singles, second men's singles between Xiao Junfeng of China and Rasmus Gemke of Denmark. Only one previous meeting